day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, it is time to make a car for 2023. Of course, I'm going to start by hitting new 3D design. Up here, we're going to name it car. I'm going to put my initials, and I'm going to put 2023 because this one is brand new. Friends, we're going to start by bringing out a cube. I'm going to set it on the work plane, and then I want to change its measurements right here. I'm going to make the length 70. I'm going to take the width, and I'm going to tell you a good number is 45, and let's set the height to 25. This is just going to be a fun little car. I've got other cars. You can check for those links up here. I do want to set the radius of this to 2. That makes it a little bit rounded. Let's actually try 5 and see if we like that better. I do think that's going to be a cooler car. Now, friends, we're going to make this so fast. Next, we're going to add a windshield. And this is so cool because of Tinkercad's cruising feature. We can drop it right where it goes. Now it's aimed the wrong direction, so we're gonna use another amazing tool, the mirror, to flip it over. Now we can squish it so it looks the way we want, pick the measurements we want. I'm gonna tell you to type the number 35. Remember, this other one was 45. So then when we select the two of them, we can choose a line, which is the shortcut L, or right here. Make the red one the boss, and align it just like that. I want to make my windshield move back, so I'm going to use the arrow keys. I think that is pretty nifty. Friends, now I want to cut in a quick seating area. We're going to do that with what's called a hole cube. You can set it right on top. I'm going to change the measurements. I want to make it 40 this way, once again remembering that we had 45 that way, and then I'm going to only make it 30 this way. Use the arrow keys to nudge it back so it's under the windshield. I think that's going to work good. And then remember this. Since we have 20 height and we've got 25 height, we want to push this down 20. I'm going to tell you to do it this way. Switch to a 5mm nudge and then do control down arrow. 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4 times 5 is 20. Bingo, it is sunk in. I'm going to grab those two. Let's choose a line. Once again, that's the letter L. Make the red one the boss, and we want the middle alignment. We're going to take those two shapes, and we're going to do Control-G to group them. There you've got your cool area inside your car. I can move my windshield up. I am going to set my nudge back to 1mm until I need a 5mm nudge again, but that's looking pretty darn fun. Let's take this window and make it transparent by hitting T for transparency. Next up, I want to cut in wheels. We're going to do that with this shape. Notice when you bring it out, it lets us pick which way we want to set it. I want to set it just like that, but I want to rotate it 90 degrees. Friends, if you rotate, if you move away from the item, it's 1 degree at a time. If you stay inside that blue circle, it's 22 and a half degrees at a time. If you hold shift, it is 45 degrees at a time, which is perfect for our part of the project. I need to turn this into a hole, so we're going to simply click on the hole choice, and then we want to cut out where the wheels go. I'm going to tell you to change this width to 12, and then we're going to do Control D, and I'm going to do shift nudge. Notice that way it goes 10 times. And I'm going to get those lined up how I want. And then I'm going to shift select the two of them. And I'm going to group them, which is Control G. Now the reason we did that, I'll show you in a second. But first we're going to do Control D and shift nudge all the way to the other side. Now we're going to select those two. Choose L for align. Click this. And we want to go to this edge. And now we're going to grab these two. Choose L for align, make the red one the boss, and do that as well. Bingo, our wheels are on both sides. You can select it, and you can hit group or control G. You've now got a place for your cool wheels. All right, friends, so we have got a place to put our wheels, but as you can see, our wheels cut in too far. Watch this. If we double click, we can edit that and I'm going to just move these out so they don't cut into that area. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, just using my arrow keys to get to the edge. And let's see what this looks like. I think that's going to work just as well. And now, friends, we need to find our wheels. Well, today we're going to get our wheels from the vehicles and machines. There are a few cool ones you can pick from. I'm going to use these standard white walls. Notice when you bring it out, it says where do you want to put it. I want to put it in that hole. If I zoom in, is it going to let me get all the way in there? I can't tell. Holy cow, check it out. It did land on that face. Now let's use shift drag to scale it down so it's the right size. That looks pretty good, and I just need to nudge it into place. If it had not dropped on that side, I would just click on the work plane, click where I wanted it. Once you have that set exactly the way you want, press D to drop. Notice if you want to be more precise, you can change your nudge to 0.5. And then I'm going to do Control D and Shift Nudge to move it back to the other spot. Let's put the work plane back down on the ground. That shortcut is W. And then I'm going to grab this entire ride and do D to drop. So now it raised our wheels up off the ground. We do want to put the wheels on the other side. Are you ready for this? I'm drawing a box that touches just the two wheels. I'm going to do Control D, put the work plane right where the new wheels go, and hit the letter D to drop them. Because these things look the same from both directions, we're done, and we can put the work plane back down. How cool is that? Alright friends, you can right click drag and see this from any corner. You can also use the cool view cube. You can zoom. You can use home to get to the exact size you want. Right now we're going to add a super fun headlight. It's going to be two parts. We're going to use the tube and we're going to use the half sphere. First, when you bring out the tube, because of cruising, we get to pick where we want to put it. I'm going to put it right there. And then I want to teach you about parameters. Set this to 6 and press enter. Set the wall thickness to 1 and press enter. And you can see that's a decent looking headlight. I do want to make it round. I am not going to do a bevel. I am going to look at it from a side. Notice I'm using the corner. And I'm going to shrink it back to size 2. If you want to actually type the number, that's super slick. I'm also going to set my nudge back to 1. I want to put a piece inside here. Once again, that is going to be the half sphere. When I bring it out, boom, it drops. Now I'm going to do another cool trick, shift squeeze to shrink it down. I know I want it to be something like 10 to get inside there. Absolutely perfect. How fun is that? I'm going to make it a little thinner. Notice if you use the black handle, it just moves the one direction at a time, which is what I was hoping for. I'm going to make this one yellow. I'm going to make the outline blue. I think that looks pretty neat. I am going to click one and then shift select the other, and I'm going to group them. Initially they changed to one color, but I want to turn on multicolor. I can then nudge them to the exact spot I want. If you don't like what you did, do Control Z. I'm going to nudge that over and I'm going to do Control Up to raise it up. I think I want it to be a tiny bit smaller. So I'm going to put the work plane back here. And now when I hold down shift, it shrinks the way I want. And I think that is the exact size I like. I'm going to nudge it up, do Control D, and then I'm going to nudge it over. And I do want those to line up exactly in the middle. So I'm going to shift select them. I'm going to group them. I'm going to put the work plane back on the ground and then shift select the car body and do a line to get them back right in the middle. Friends, our car is looking pretty fantastic. We do need seats. I have got a tutorial that shows you how to make seats. I will make sure there is a link up in here in the corner so that you can get to it. I'm going to type the word seat, and there are two of these to choose from. I've got one that is code blocks, and I've got the other that is made in traditional. Once you click on it and bring it out, because of the cool cruising tool, you can just drop it where it goes. I am going to F to fit view, shift shrink it, do Control D, and I'm going to nudge the other one over here so that my car has seats. Bingo, just like that. Once again, these tutorials will be up here in the corner, and they only take a few minutes. Friends, our convertible is looking pretty slick. I want to add something now back on the back. I'm going to close this, and I want you to switch back to basic shapes, and we're going to search for something called the bent pipe. When you find it, I always recommend making it a favorite. That way you can find it easier. When we bring this out, it's going to be kind of unique. I want you to actually set it on the front. The reason is because we're going to use this as a roll cage. So trust me here, we're going to make it 180 degrees. Notice when you press enter, it starts to look like a roll cage that's going to be back behind us. We're going to change the measurements. Right now it's crazy big. We're going to take it down to 3. We're also going to change this lead in and lead out. I'm going to make that 10 and 10. And then we want to put this up on top of our vehicle. Well, friends, we're going to use the new cruising tool. When we hit C to cruise, we can now grab this, and we want to grab it. Check this out. I'm going to click one more time right here. Now I can bring it back to the back. Notice if your back is not super big and flat and you can't find it, you could set it here and nudge it back. But friends, that's how awesome the cruising tool is. It lets us set things exactly how we want them for use in our car. Now we can see that this is too darn high, so we're going to simply change these to 5 and 5 and press enter. And when we press D, it drops down just like it's supposed to, and that is pretty sweet. I do want to pick a cooler color. I'm going to go with the yellow because I think that fits the car. I got one more tool for you, friends. We're going to close this, and this is the epic scribble. We're going to put the scribble on the side of the car. The scribble tool allows you to draw things. Here's how you clear it. Instead of drawing with that tool, though, we're going to use this one. Friends, we're going to use this tool right here to make a fun flame. Notice I am just drawing a loop, and I'm coming back. Now I'm coming back in, making another loop, and another loop, and another loop, and then finishing it off. That's going to be my flame. It is not perfect. If you've got a part you don't like, you notice you can erase it. We can also hit clear. Watch this though. When we hit done, we can squish this and squish this to make it actually look like flames, which is pretty darn fun and pretty darn quick. I'm going to do control up to raise that up. Once again, I've still got all my little measurements here. The black handle lets me squish it and squish it to make it look pretty darn fantastic. Of course, you can do that again and again until you're happy, happy. I'm going to leave this alone. I am going to do Control D. I'm going to put the work plane over here by doing W and pressing D to drop it. Notice I do need to move it in. I'm going to do that by just nudging it with the handle, just like that. All lined up and looking pretty spiffy. I'm going to put the work plane back on the ground. I'm going to add an instant license plate. Once again, bring out the block, set it on here. This time I'm just going to squish it manually. Bing, bing. Pick a different color. I'm going to make my license plate blue. I'm going to put words on it. Once again, these drop right on it. You can put whatever word you want. Mine, obviously, is going to be HLMT. And I'm going to put the 23 on it because, friends, remember, if you ever tag your stuff with that, I'll take a look at it. This time I'm going to do Alt-Shift, and I'm going to shrink that down till it fits. Notice we can do F to fit view and get that all lined up. I'm going to select this bottom chunk, do a line, and let's set it to the car's middle. And now we can look at this from a side, shrink it in a little more. I'm going to give these rounded corners, put a little 2 on it. I'm going to change my nudge to 0.5 and nudge that in one chunk. I'm going to change this to a cool color. Let's go white. And I'm going to nudge it in once again with those arrow keys. We can look at it, stretch it, whatever we want to make ours look as cool as we want it. While we're back here, don't forget you can add taillights. Once again, bring them out, hold down shift, squish them to whatever size you want, pick the color you want. I'm going to make mine a yellow. click on it, do Control D, Shift Nudge to get it to the other side. Of course, we can Shift Select and Control G group those. Shift Select, L for Align, and bingo, snap them so they are perfect on our vehicle. Once they're both there, you can even customize them, make them look however you want. Friends, this car is yours. Obviously, we need steering wheels. You can add a front grille. You can add bumpers. Maybe make your bumper with this shape. But you can have a ton of fun making your own car in 2023. Friends, when you're ready to show off your project, one cool thing you can do is shut off the grid. You can also pick a new background color. Like, say I'm going to put a dark purple. And then when I click out here, boom, you've got a nice background for screenshots. You also can show the whole world by clicking on the Tinkercad button and then clicking on the properties. Make sure your project has a name. I'm going to call mine Make a Car in 2023. The tutorial will be there when I finish in a minute. And of course, here's notes for how to find all the things I create and how to reach me. Of course, add tags about your design. And as I mentioned a minute ago, if you tag it with HLMT23, I search that tag every day and I'll check out to see what you made. Finally, friends, make it public. And then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here and follow the tutorial to gain epic skills. Of course, friends, once you make it public, if you zip to the gallery, of course, you'll get to see all the awesome staff picks. But if you shut that off, you'll be able to check out all the amazing recent designs. Of course, if you see something awesome, make sure you give it a reaction. It may take a while for your design to pop up, but I do also want to recommend checking it out at this view too, so you can see all the awesome projects. Oh my gosh, Puss in Boots, that's so funny. Friends, I hope you had a ton of fun with the tutorial, and I hope you make awesome cars, and then share them with me in the gallery as well. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button, and last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.